Matt was a legend in the nightlife in New York City.
Go from a dancer, athlete, dancer, bouncer, party animal, club promoter, venue owner. Gerardo Velez. I'm a percussionist, a harmonica player, singer, and dancer. One of my dear friends, Matt DeMatt, and I go back a long time.
I'd have to say the first time I met him, if memory serves me well, would be Heartbreak.
The Heartbreak was that type of club that celebrities would come to. There would be famous people and there would be infamous people as well.
Everybody that was anybody of the day was there. And it was just a great, great party. It was a diner by day and a club by night.
I'd go to Heartbreak and there was Matt at the door. Big guy, great hair, good looking guy. You know, and he had an edge to him. You know, and I had my edge to me. And we met and we kind of snarled at each other, guy to guy, the way guys posture. And then we became instant friends after that.
Me being a doorman wasn't just becoming a doorman. It was a job that I took very seriously. I made it a point to know everybody that was in the scene who was a celebrity and then who the celebrity's friends were. So this way the celebrities would come down regularly.
After the Heartbreak, it was Spodiotti's was the big place.
I walked in the door, I took a look at it. It was a 100-year-old bar and I fell in love and I said, this place I'm going to do very well at. I have to get this job. I know what to do, and I'm going to blow this place up. Next week I had 200 people, week after 400, then 1,000.
Matt could bring the crowds, shift the crowds wherever he needed to. You know, and it's not like today when you can do that with a couple of clicks.
He was a disciple of Fat Frankie, who basically started promotion in New York.
Fat Frankie ran Monday nights in New York. Monday night is the hardest night to get anything going. And Frankie had the list of doom.
And then Matt just took what Fat Frankie taught him and ran with it and did it better and cooler even than Fat Frankie, because it was a little bit less like A-list celebrity, a little bit more rock and roll.
As a promoter, I met more people. People not only wanted to know me like they did as a doorman, but that moved me into more of, let's say, management and being myself, because I ran the business on my own.
There was always some tension as well as sexiness and excitement in the air when Matt DeMatt threw an event.
And you know, when there was ever a possibility to have live music, he always was the one who made sure. And you know, and that would hurt his own pocketbook too, because somebody's got to pay for the band. We pull up with the limo, yo, right in, a booth would be ready. You know, the artists would be taken care of. And that personal touch is what made him, I think, very successful.
If the fall fashion swimwear showdown was too much for you, then I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. Wow! Before
they hit the lights. Wrestling threw me a big curve. I wasn't ready for it. I got thrown into it. There was no warning of what I was doing.
Oh, Maddie in the house! We're back in ECW New York. And if you think things were wild, crazy, and mad before, wait till you get a load of this!
Oh. Acting is really what I wanted to be. I just didn't realize that I was acting on all those TV shows week after week.
For you, man, I'll do it for you.
The traveling, the no money was exhausting. I didn't see that was a place I wanted to be for the rest of my life.
Matt was in some great movies. Bullet, Basketball Diaries, Searching for Bobby Fischer, The Professional.
I didn't know that he was in the movie. And all of a sudden, this scene comes up, and there he, Matt! And I'm in the theater and I'm screaming.
I was acting anyway, just because it was my personality. I was always on. So always being on translated to me doing certain parts. So I was asked to do a part here, a part there.
It went from something that he needed to do to something that he wanted to do.
Look at this. Look at this. See this? None of you potsies ever want anything like this.
Do me a favor. Shut up. We're trying to play a game here, all right?
The evolution of things are changing. So as Matt, that's why he finally took root here at the Gaslight and made it very successful.
Love you, baby!
I worked for Matt at Gaslight, and I kind of never left. When Gaslight first opened, you couldn't go outside.
Transvestite hookers, and it was seedy, but it was brilliant down here.
Gaslight started the influx of business because there used to be sex clubs and a bagel shop, so there really was nothing there for anybody to go to unless you were into raunchy sex or get a bagel.
The first and only. Really, started the whole area. I would have to say that, meatpacking.
Matt was able to open up his Rolodex and call a bunch of people and really transition Gaslight into kind of this odd place in a pretty grimy neighborhood into a very cool place in what is now one of the hottest neighborhoods in Manhattan.
You look at Matt and different guys, you say, oh, they're just about parties. But he was smart enough to turn his party element with his partners into this successful venue.
People that come to Matt's Promotions are not just becoming because it's a good party. They're coming to support Matt because Matt is cooler than the Fonz.
We are moving to New Orleans, no question about it. We don't know exactly when. It will. It's not immediate. It's not tomorrow, but it's not that far away either.
I want to be in a place where age doesn't matter and I want people to have a good time, and that's really why I'm going to New Orleans.
New Orleans is an awesome place, and who better to bring some New York City to New Orleans than Matt to Matt?
But I don't think they've ever seen what I want to bring down there, which would be little food, little personality, little music, little DJ, and that's about all I'm going to say about it, and an award-winning chef.
I mean, that's huge for Matt not to be a fixture in New York nightlife. It is, without a doubt.
You know, this is New York. There'll be someone trying to be Matt to Matt. You know, there'll be, they'll fly in and try, you know, eat the crumbs that are left behind Matt, the crumbs that he leaves as he goes.
No matter where he goes, you can't take New York City out of Matt. He represents this city, and he represents it well.
New Orleans has really endeared me, as well as I think that I've made friends there very fast. I think it's going to be the next New York for me.